Come on there, man. It's time.
I'll never poke.
Várasdas, vot is dasha mayesh. Várasdas. Perhaps the question right at this moment would be, what was that? Well, let me tell you what that was, and then I'll tell you what this is. What that was Fritzy Mosh Bender singing his little song, and it was a song that he liked to call, and I gotta read it right off the paper, I get it wrong, I'm an old man. Song written by Fritzy Mosh Bender for this particular time and day, which is the end of the age. I shall not hokey, so thus I shan't pokey. It's a song, it's an anti-hokey pokey song, and I agree wholeheartedly with it. I don't like it. It's where I draw the line. It is anathema unto me. Why, Laban? Don't you like the hokey pokey? It's an what could be so wrong with that? It's harmless little. Well, let me tell you something. You know, one thing I don't like about it is the fact that somewhere, always out there, somewhere in the world, there's a retirement home or a nursing home or something, and there's always this strange, weird, you know, cheerful exercise person forcing these old people to do the hokey pokey, and I can't stand it. They don't want to do that. I mean, these are 90-year-old men, you know, fought in war, and a 90-year-old woman raised children, raised grandchildren, worked and strove through life, and then, you know, in their golden years, some, you know, bouncy nut is, come in, put your right hand in. Oh, no. I would never force anyone to do such a thing. And now you might even say, Laban, why are you getting so upset about the hokey-pokey? Well, let me tell you, I can't even say it, you know. But anyway, okay. Don't get me started. But I already am, so now she phlegm. Now I'm getting phlegm. Oh, my goodness. Satan will use even the most innocent things to get, you know, to confuse things, or, you know, even innocent, especially innocent things. What could be more innocent than just eating a little piece of fruit off of a tree, you know? What could be more innocent than that? Well, you know, I saw something on the internet, and now it's going back a few years. And they may not even be doing it anymore. But it was once out there, the thought has been planted. That's what Satan likes to do, plant thoughts, you know. So, take a look at this, and then we'll talk. Well, there you go, folks. Now, this headline's a few years old, but even so, there is, right there in front of you, the Holy Ghost Hokey Pokey. The article says, I just read a few lines, we've got a lot to deal with in the church right now. Oy vey, I don't like that. We've got, just to name a few things, Word of Faith, the new mystics, manifest sons of God, the emergence Christianity, and now we've got a full-blown Holy Ghost Hokey Pokey on our hands. How does that grab you? Well, you know, just take a look. This is, you know, this is the, here's a little video they put on of it. I'll just show you just a bit here.
I'll tell you, 3 weeks ago, we did a Friday Night School of the Spirit, and we saw 12 people heal the Word of Knowledge and 40 heal during the Holy Ghost Hokey Pokey.
Oh, boy.
Let's just go ahead and do that and see what the Lord does.
Yeah, let's see what he does.
You guys okay to do the Holy Ghost Hokey Pokey?
Maybe he'll come and do the Hokey Pokey video.
All right, Brian's going to lead us in the Holy Ghost Hokey Pokey. Mm.
Put your right hand in, put your right hand out. You put your right hand in, you put your right hand out.
Oh my, and I suppose you shake it all about. Come on, folks, what is this? You know, this is pathetic. You got people out there doing the Holy Ghost Hokey Pokey and saying people are being healed. Is that biblical? No, I don't think that's biblical. That's not how it was done. Healings were not done by sticking in your head and shaking it all about. No, no, no. What are they going to do next? What's next? The Maranatha Macarena? Perhaps on April 15th, we can do the Blood Moon Walk. I give vault on get me started.
Is that biblical? I'm sorry. No, no. That is not biblical. Now you're saying, Lame, you're getting too strict. You're being legalistic about all this. It's a simple little thing. No, no, no. You don't do that. I'm sure, you know, before, you know, when Yeshua was, you know, ready to heal someone, you know, it's like, okay, come on, get in a cycle. And what about the blind man? Of course it would work with the blind man, you know, put your right eye in. Oh, come on now. Shake it up. Oh, goodness gracious. Yeah. I'm sorry, you know, this is not good for, you know, young believers. You know, they put the internet on, they see something like this. They walk into a church, you know, and they doing the hokey pokey. Oh, my goodness. This is, you know... Now, of course, you know, I mean, you're going to say, too, you know, well, Laban, you just don't like it. No, I can't. I don't like it.
No pokey, no pokey, no pokey, no, no pokey, no pokey.
But that has nothing to do with the fact that you don't, you know, it goes in like with them other kinds of churches. There's a church where you can cluck like a chicken. Is that right? You know? I've seen it on the internet. You know, it's you go in and the pastor's up there clucking like a chicken. And then you got one church where you show up naked. No, I'm sorry. You go dressed, but once you're there, you can get undressed and be naked in the church. The pastor comes out with nothing on. That's wonderful. And then there's a church where you move like a cow. There's one you dress like a clown, you know? I mean, if you're going outside of what the scriptures tell you when it comes to behavior, when it comes to worship, it's not right. You can't do it. No, no, no. God will not be mocked. Right, Diane? Wherever you are, Diane and Dan, God bless you, Elohim, bless you both. And so, you know, I'm going to stick to it, me and Fritzy. We shall not hokey. And thus, we shall not pokey. Oh, this. Maybe you're wondering what that was. Well, that was something that some old friends of mine and myself used to refer to as the gesture. When we wanted to be, when something caused us to become spontaneous and sincere, we definitely conveyed a lot of spontaneity and sincerity back in those days. Well, anyway. Ooh! Oh my goodness, I sound like W.C. Fields. Got a little crick in my hip. I gotta get loose. I gotta get, you know, do something, get a little loose. You know? Have to, surely maybe go out dancing soon, hey? But not that, you know. I got a little surprise for you, but I'm gonna bring that up in just a second. I wanna reiterate one more time about what I was talking about before. the HP, and I don't mean Hewlett-Packard. For those of you out there that are young in your faith, still on the milk, trying to get on the meat of the word of Elohim, still trying to get into the deeper things, but before that, you are on the milk. And, you know, someone young in the faith, they go into a building that your professors to believe in Yeshua, and they're clucking like a chicken, or they dancing around with the put your right. No, that's got to stop. You got to look in the scriptures here and see how it will tell you how to worship Him, how to praise our Elohim with psalms and with wonderful prayers. You don't do that kind of stuff. And that's still on the internet, you know. I don't know if they're in a building somewhere still doing that thing that I was talking about before. But it's on the internet, and it shouldn't be. Somehow or another, we should try to get that crap off of there. But anyway, I'm done with that. Well, gotta get loose. I was gonna do a video more about, you know, what's going on in the world. You know, we are in the days of Noah. You can't get away from it. It's in the movies. Now, if that's not a sign, I don't know what is. We're living in the days of Lot, and there ain't a lot of days left. But, you know, it's a little slow. It's not that it's slow, but it seems like sometimes, you know, Elohim pulls back a little bit, gives us a breather, you know, from, you know, bam, smack, rap, all this stuff happening all at once, you know. But we're still, you know, we're wondering what's going on in Ukraine and the plane. Oh,
Do it, man.
What's happening in Ukraine?
Yeah.
While they're still looking for a plane.
Okay.
Oh, my goodness, it's insane.
Oh, my.
Yeah, then a smack and there I came.
Smacking good.
But I thought I'd do something a little different. I got contacted by the originator of this channel. That's right, Mr. Zeus Marshbender. He sent me a telegram. He lives down the street. He sent me a telegram to ask me a question. Who gets a telegram in 2014? I do. From Zeus Marshbender. But you know, he's giving me this opportunity to come on and talk to you all with what is this, with Laban. And he asked if I wanted to show something that he discovered many years ago. It's never been really reported. And maybe some of you out there have seen what Zeus saw all those years ago. And perhaps, you know, you can comment on it or something. But there we go. And, well, here it is.
Hi there, folks. Hey there, folks. This here is Zeus Mossbender. I originated the what's called Zeus Mossbender channel. Want to say thank you to Laban Schnell, with his show, What Is This? What Is This? I can't say it just once. This here is Zeus Mossbender. He tried to get me to appear visually. I'm not into that. I just like to do my thing. Get out of the way. Do my thing. That's what I do. I have a friend named T.T., and back in school, he used to call me Zeus the Recluse. So, I also want to say thank you to my brother Fritzy for turning on a button and making my, you know, record, pressing the record. I want to show y'all something I filmed some years back. I was out in the back here trying to film, seeing if there was any, you know, waiting for flowers to come up, see if there was any croakers out there in the back by the hillbilly's house. And me and my friend Gil was out. He was there too. Gil, he's since gone on Be With The Lord. Gil Fisher, very strange man. He was very perplexed by just about everything he looked at. He saw a table once. That's a big table. What's a big table? I pondered on that for years about Gil. But we was out there, and we had the video camera. It was one of them old Panasonics, and it was, you know, heavy, real heavy. It was big like a house. And, you know, we was playing rock, paper, scissors, seeing who was going to have to carry it. And I don't know how it took about an hour. You know, we think the same, I guess. But we was out there, and And I didn't want to carry it because it was, you know, big like a house, and it was heavy, and can't really carry a house. Unless, of course, you know, you're like a tortoise. But, this is what we saw, and I just thought I'd put it out there for you to comment on. It's a sight. It's a sight, and many people have seen UFOs, or some people have claimed to see inexplicable things, you know, like the Yeti, or a Bigfoot, or Senator Barbara Mikulski, you know, those things. And, well, I just want to put it out there for you. Check it out, and if you got a comment, and if you've ever seen this, please, you know, love to know. So, here it is.